الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته أيها الأحبة. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is your brother Abdul Muhaymin. I'm greeting you with the greeting of people of the Jannah, which is Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, once again I'm here to show you that inshallah we are apart, you know, physically. Alhamdulillah, we are together morally and spiritually. Our hearts are together. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. I hope everybody is having good Ramadan, and that inshallah we are having more courage in this month of Ramadan, even though we are forced to be home, to be separated. Inshallah, I hope we are taking this moment of home staying to do more. Because يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني نعمتان مغبون فيهما كثير من الناس الصحة والراحة. If we look, we will see that maybe our work hours have been cut off, or maybe we're not even working at all, some of us. So that means we have more time. So we need to think about that and take an advantage of this free moment and do more. Because he said there is a two ni'mah, two blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People forget about it sometimes. They don't take an opportunity to use that for what is going to benefit them in this life and life hereafter. Well, the two things are, you know, health and also free moment, free time. So, brothers in Islam, my today khatira is to see together, is there a difference between al-ibadah wal-a'malu al-khayriya, what we call worship, and also the some good actions. Al-a'malu al-khayriya, you know, the some other good deeds which are not salat or fasting. So, brothers in Islam, for us to understand that if there is a difference between these two things, we need to go back to what Allah said to us. Allah SWT said in the Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون إن الله هو الرزاق. إخوة الإيمان, Allah said that He did not create us but to worship Him. So if you talk about worship in the what is al-ibadah, we need to understand what the ulama said about it. So, ila al-imam ibn Taymiyyah an ma'na al-ibada fi hazihi al-aya faqala al-ibada kullu ma yuhibbuhu Allah min qawlin aw amalin aw i'tiqadin kullu ma yuhibbuhu Allah wa yardahu min al-qawli wal-amali. He said any the act, the worshipping is any action coming from you and any word coming from your mouth and any intention you have in your heart is considered as a worship. So that's why we understand that if we understand that meaning, that worship is a, you know, is everything you will do to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything you will do to get a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is called ibadah. فإذن فقط, we can now see that there is a different kind of ibadah. فنقول أن هناك أنواع من العبادة، فهناك العبادات العقدية، وهناك العبادات القولية، وهناك العبادات تتعلق بحق الله، ويدخل في العبادات كذلك المعاملات بين الناس. So worship can be a different things we do. So saying good word, having good intention, those act of worship we are doing, praying, fasting, all this is part of the worship is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, our interaction between one another also is called, or it can be an ibadah also, ikhwat al-iman. It would be ibadah if you do with good intention. If you do some of them because you following the step of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then it would be ibadah, ikhwat al-iman. So, brother, ikhwat al-islam, so if we understand that, we will understand that ibadah is something general, and there is many ways of ibadah. Sam al-amalul khayriya. So maybe we understand from the amalul khayriya, you know, maybe making a sadaqah, helping the masjid with some activities, organizing the masjid, maybe cleaning the masjid, for example, organizing a youth camp, for example, or organizing summer camp for the kids, for example, organizing, you know, any community dinner, organizing, you know, a community meeting. All this is dakhil fi al-amal khayriya, and contributing for any social work. Anything is good for the community. Social, ikhwat al-iman, is all called, you know, al-amal al-khayriya. So can we focus on one more than other one, ikhwat al-iman? Also, we're going to also understand that al-ibadat tanqasimu imma ila annaha fardiyatun wa imma in annaha yani tatawwu'iyatun. We understand also ibadah, as we say, it can be mandatory or it can be non-mandatory. So we have mandatory ibadah, we have non-mandatory ibadah. The one are mandatory, like praying five times a day, like, you know, fasting the month of Ramadan, those are mandatory. So there is another one which is not mandatory. So that's why we understand هناك العبادات الفردية التي تجب عليك أن تقوم بها. وإذا لم تقوم بها تأثم. وهناك بعض العبادات يعني من نفس الجنس ولكن ليست يعني فريضة وليست يعني واجبة على الإنسان، إنما هو يفعله المسلم من باب تطوع وبحسن النية وحسن أداء هذا التطوع الإنسان يجد أجرا عند الله سبحانه وتعالى. So the ibadah, the one a mandatory, you would do it. So there is some ibadah, even though they are kind of also part of, they look like the other ibadah, like praying. We pray five times a day, but we have some nafila prayer. So like we do it Taraweeh, for example, or we doing few rakat after each salat or before some of the salawat. So ikhwat al-iman. So when you're doing those, you're doing that with a good intention and doing it correctly, you will get the reward, ikhwat al-iman. That's why you call it tatawwu. Now to say also, fil mu'amalati hunaka ma hiya yani wajiba. Also in the interaction between us, there is some stuff they are mandatory to do. Like in taking care of your parents, for example, that's mandatory. Taking care of your family is a mandatory. You know, anybody in your charge, in your household, is a mandatory. So, but there are other things, for example, taking, you know, helping poor people in the community, in the society, even though they are not mandatory on you, but if you do it, you get more reward, ikhwat al-iman. So, my advice here, make sure we balance between these things. We do the fara'id as it is, and then we bring also those non-mandatory act of worship. We do it as we can, ikhwat al-iman. And also, those social activities, social interaction in between us, the one which are mandatory, we do it correctly, and the one are not mandatory on you, we do as we can also, and do a lot of effort on that, ikhwat al-iman. So, brothers in Islam, in this month of Ramadan, as we know, any effort you will do, your reward will be multiplied from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything you will do is a blessing. and especially in this difficult moment, it's very important that we focus on doing the fara'id as it is, and also doing a lot of nawafil. It's true that we are not able to gather in the masajid, or still can get in a reward by doing those good deeds in the mas in our house, in our bait, inshallah. Ikhwat al-Iman. Also, to finish this khatira, let not be sad because we are not able to gather in the masajid. Look, there is a hadith where Rasul said, when a human being, a Muslim, he been going to the masajid all the time. He, when he hear about that of salah, he will go. Or is it, non-mandatory, for example, fasting, or fasting, let's say he fast Monday, Thursday, or some, and then for some reason, he cannot do anymore. He cannot go to a masjid, maybe for sickness or for a lack of safety, for example. So, do you know that all the age, he became old, or he cannot also walk to the masjid, or he don't have the way to go to the masjid, Ikhwat al-Iman. Do we know that we still get the reward? You wish to go to the masjid all the time. That like now, we used to gather in the masjid for the taraweeh with a good intention, because we love to see each other in the masjid, we love to hug each other in the masjid, we love to make a dua for each other. But you know, and still in this month of Ramadan came, and then we have problem, we cannot gather in the masjid. I know we all, the heart still attached with the masjid. Our heart, I know, is attached with the masjid right now. You wish you we gathered in the masjid, but alhamdulillah, we understand is by the will of God that we're not going to be there for now. So, but remember, you will still get the reward of what you used to do all the time. If you are not able to come to the masjid and your heart is still attached to the masjid, you're willing to come, but something is preventing you, remember, you will still get your reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala complete. So don't be sad, Ikhwat al-Iman. Let's continue doing what we can do. Let's do a lot of istighfar, a lot of the dhikr, a lot of the dua. Let's make dua for one another. Let's make dua for those maybe we know they are affected with the, you know, with the sickness, or those who are affected, you know, with you know, the sickness, or even they're affected, they're not sick, but the situation economy, you remember, you will still get your reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala complete. So don't be sad, Ikhwat al-Iman. Let's continue doing what we can do. Let's do a lot of istighfar, a lot of the dhikr, a lot of the dua. Let's make dua for one another. Let's make dua for those maybe we know they are affected with the, you know, with the sickness, or those who are affected, you know, with you know, the sickness, or even they're affected, they're not sick, but the situation economically can and affected them. Let's make dua for them, and let's be there for them also, with telling them good word to them, inshallah. So my advice for you, I make dua for you brothers and sisters and in the community. I really miss you all. I hope we can meet again, inshallah. But alhamdulillah, that's why I'm making this short khatira, and to send you my salam, my love, and let you know also that I'll miss you, inshallah. And don't forget to make dua for your brother Abdul Muhaymin, and inshallah we make dua for everybody. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Allahumma rabbana inna zalamna anfusana fa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. I also want to, you know, take an opportunity to say thank you for the masjid management. Really, they've been doing a lot of good deeds to make sure we can stay connected, to make sure we are not disconnected. Yeah, that's why they've been doing all kind of things to do. Wallahi, jazakumullah khair al-jaza. All the management people are in charge of the masjid, doing. Sometimes they're not sleeping. Sometimes they find any way to make sure the masjid can still running, the community still together. I think they're doing a great job. May Allah reward them. Barakallahu fi umrikum wa fi a'malikum wa fi أولادكم وذرياتكم ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن بأن يتقبل منا جميعا وأن يعفو عنا ذنوبنا وزلاتنا. هذا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. This is your brother Abdul Muhaymin. Inshallah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.